What's up guys, it's Bones, and today I'm gonna show you how to trim a Doberman's toenails. So today I'm gonna give you guys a kind of crash course on how I trim her toenails. It's something I've done every week since I've got her. And it's gotten easier over time, but it's still not a perfect production, so bear with while we go through this process. It's not a complicated one, but it can be a frustrating one if you guys have never done this before with your Doberman, or if you're just completely new to trimming dogs' toenails. I use a Dremel. This, to me, works a lot better than a traditional clipper because you can go back and go down millimeter by millimeter on their toenails. That way you don't cut it too far, or if you do cut it too far, it's just a little bit of blood that comes through and it's not necessarily going to be a major issue. Once you start seeing the white, which is called the quick, within her toenail, that's when you know is probably about a good spot to stop. I generally try to round the toenail so that way it's more of kind of a round blunt object. Every length of toenail is different from dog to dog. I am not an expert when it comes to this stuff. You know, there's vets out there and everything who are way more skilled on this. This is just what has worked for me over the past 2 years of owning her. So hopefully this video helps you guys out and your journey when it comes to trimming your dog's toenails. So as you can see, she loves getting at her treat. It's one of the few times that I do give her a treat is during this process. So while that entertains her, I usually like to start out with the back legs because I find that the front paws are easier. That's maybe different for your dog, but that's what I found out for her. So I start out with the back ones. And a little tip for you guys, if you do get frustrated with this, just do the ones that they present right away, especially if you're starting out, because trying to get them all done in one paw, you know, may not be the best for your situation. But let's dive in and let's get to this. What I find easiest when trimming her toenails is I like to be over top of her. That way I kind of have control of her. But whatever way you can keep them like the most just relaxed and not moving around is going to be your best case scenario. So there might be different positions that work better for you. I've just found if I can be over top of her, that's how I start. So like I said, I'll start it on the back ones and we'll go from there. Now we're gonna move on to the front paws. The front paws I think are a little bit easier. Like I said, once you start seeing the white in the toenail, that's probably a good sign to stop there. I like to take the Dremel and round out the toenail. That way it kind of has a nice blunt end to it. It's not sharp if anything were to like they jump on you or furniture or anything that. So like I said, it's not necessarily about taking a whole bunch off, especially if you just start doing this. Dobermans, you know, they kind of walk up on like a high heel, like on their pads. I generally like to have it so that way their toenails don't touch the hardwood floor or the pavement. I think it's very healthy for them and it's just better for everybody. So we're gonna work on the front ones here. We'll just keep going. All right. Well, hopefully this video was helpful for you guys. I know it's not the perfect situation and every dog is gonna be different. As you can tell, there's a few times when she doesn't necessarily like getting it done, but you know what, for the most part, she does pretty well and I can't complain because I know there's a lot of dogs out there that you can't even get close to. A couple of pro tips that I can give for you, you know, like with the Dremel, start this young with them because then they can acclimate to it as they get older. You know, when we first started with her trimming her toenails with this, it was a little bit more of a production. As you can see now, she does take it pretty well. Things that would help is if you take the Dremel with just having it out, if you're introducing this to a dog for the first time, would just be have it around them, give them treats when this thing is around. Then eventually you can move on to like maybe turning it on with no attachment on it and maybe eventually just kind of touch them with it so they can feel the vibration so they don't necessarily get scared or frightened when this thing does come around. Because when she sees this now, she understands that this means treats and she loves treats. She's such a food-driven dog. If your dog isn't food-driven, it's gonna be probably a lot more difficult to trim your dog's toenails. So, I mean, the best of luck out there. Let me know if I can help in any way, shape, or form in the comments. I appreciate you guys following along in this channel. If you like this type of content, maybe consider subscribing.